If you are shopping for a home, you may be in luck. We told you last week about some credit scoring changes that could help borrowers, potentially making it easier to get a home loan. But there are some risks, as always. Diana Olick explains.
Just over a decade ago, big lenders were giving big mortgages to anyone with a pulse. And this is what happened. Today, it's much harder to get a home loan, but that has sidelined some worthy borrowers. So the vice is now loosening yet again. Two major changes in underwriting go into effect this month. First, the nation's credit rating agencies are dropping tax liens and civil judgments from consumers' profiles if they're not fully documented. That's because one in five consumers have mistakes on their credit reports. Of about 220 million Americans with a credit profile, about 7% have these credit hits. Without them, their FICO credit scores could go up by as much as 20 points. Second, Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac are increasing the amount of debt payments a borrower can have compared to their income, from 45% to 50% of pre-tax income. That is a response to today's high level of student loan debt.
We're not changing the other underwriting criteria, and we believe that the additional increment of risk for making that change is very small. And given how pristine credit has been post-crisis, we don't feel like that's an unreasonable risk to take.
But it does mean some consumers will be saddled with even more debt.
I think the main concern that I have is the fact that you have these multiple issues coming together. You have more stretched consumers. You have potentially consumers that have demonstrated credit problems in the past.
Brown says consumers who've had a tax lien or civil judgment are from 2 to 5 times more likely to be late on a payment again.
It doesn't really do a consumer well to be extended credit that they can't afford, they can't reasonably service.
But debt limits and credit scores are not the only thing lenders consider.
We look at all the other criteria for that are information rich. In terms of assessing that individual's risk profile, and they have to look good in all those other areas.
And the lending market itself isn't changing its appetite for overall risk and potential losses, so while it may loosen up in some areas of credit, it may also tighten in others. For Nightly Business Report, I'm Diana Olick in Washington.